It is considered that the spirit is the divine or transcendental part of each being, while the soul is the entity that houses the spirit and dwells in the physical body. This perspective is often found in spiritual beliefs that emphasize the connection between the individual and the divine. In this interpretation, the spirit is seen as the divine spark or sacred essence that connects the person to the divine, the eternal, or the transcendental. The soul is considered the individualized and unique part of a person that experiences earthly life and stores experiences, emotions, and learning throughout its existence. The physical body acts as the vehicle that allows the soul and spirit to interact with the material world and experience life on earth. This perspective is particularly prominent in some religious traditions such as Christianity, Judaism, Islam, and in philosophical systems like Platonism and Neoplatonism. Greetings to all members of the Apprentice Channel. This is a space dedicated to exploring the mysteries of the world and acquiring varied knowledge that allows us to reach our inner fulfillment. If you are a seeker of knowledge, we invite you to join our community and be part of it. Together, we can explore the mysteries of the world and acquire knowledge that helps us grow and develop. Welcome to the Apprentice Channel. Let's continue. In Christianity, it is maintained that the spirit is the divine part of a person, related to God and eternal. The soul is considered the individualized part residing in the body and capable of experiencing life on earth. Belief in the immortality of the soul and its destiny after death are central themes in this tradition. While the Jewish perspective on the soul may vary among different currents within Judaism, there is a common idea that the spirit is related to the divine, and the soul is the unique part of each individual that experiences life and has the ability to connect with the divine. In Islam, the spirit is associated with the divine essence and is believed to be a gift from God to every human being. The soul is the entity residing in the body and experiencing life in this world. Belief in the immortality of the soul and its accountability before God are important concepts in the Islamic faith. Neoplatonic philosophy, influenced by the teachings of Plato and developed by philosophers like Plotinus, holds a similar view where the soul is considered the individualized entity and the spirit is the transcendental and divine reality. Neoplatonic philosophy greatly influenced Christian theology and medieval philosophy. It is important to remember that although these traditions share similarities in their understanding of the relationship between spirit and soul, they may also have significant differences in terms of doctrine and specific beliefs. Additionally, other philosophies and religions may have different or more complex interpretations of these concepts. The difference between soul and spirit is a topic that has been debated throughout history in different spiritual and philosophical traditions, and definitions may vary depending on belief and perspective. Here are some of the most common differences and similarities. Nature, soul. In many religious and philosophical traditions, the soul is considered the immortal, essential, and distinctive part of a person. The soul is often associated with individuality and the unique identity of a person. It is frequently linked to the mind, personality, and emotions. Spirit. On the other hand, the spirit is often seen as a life force or energy that animates a living being. In some traditions, the spirit is believed to be a force that connects us to the external world and the divine. Immortality. Soul. In many religions, it is believed that the soul is immortal and persists after the death of the body. The fate of the soul after death is considered to depend on its actions and choices in life. Spirit. Belief in the immortality of the spirit may vary according to tradition. In some cultures and spiritual beliefs, it is held that the spirit may also be immortal, or may transition to another form of existence after death. Function. Soul. The soul is believed to be related to consciousness, morality, and the ability to experience emotions and interpersonal relationships. Some traditions consider the soul as the seat of will and decision-making. Spirit. The spirit is often associated with vitality, energy, and connection to the divine or the transcendental. In some beliefs, the spirit may be related to intuition and inspiration. The idea of thinning the soul or reducing the ego to allow for a greater manifestation from the spirit is a concept found in many spiritual traditions and philosophies. This idea is often related to the pursuit of spiritual enlightenment, self-realization, or connection with the divine. In many spiritual traditions, the ego is considered the part of us rooted in personal identity, desire, and self-assertion. To achieve a deeper connection with the spirit or divine essence, it is common to believe that one must transcend the ego and reduce its influence. This involves cultivating self-awareness and humility. The practice of meditation is a common way to thin the soul or reduce the activity of the egoic mind. Through meditation, the aim is to calm the mind, release unnecessary thoughts and desires, and allow greater access to spiritual awareness. Detachment refers to the ability to free oneself from emotional and material attachments often associated with the ego. By practicing detachment, one can experience greater freedom and openness to connect with the divine or spiritual essence. In some philosophies and spiritual currents, identification with being rather than the selfish self is encouraged. This involves recognizing a deeper and more universal reality underlying personal identity. The idea of thinning the soul may also be related to a process of spiritual transformation in which one seeks to transcend the limitations of the ego and live according to higher principles such as love, compassion, and wisdom. It is worth noting that the path to reducing the ego and manifesting from the spirit can vary significantly according to the spiritual tradition or philosophy followed. Additionally, this idea is approached differently in various religious traditions and spiritual philosophies, so it is important to explore and understand the specific practices and beliefs of the tradition that interests you. Ultimately, the goal is to live from a place of greater authenticity and connection with the spiritual or divine essence within each individual. The pursuit of perfecting the soul and transcending the individual ego to manifest from the divine is a common goal in many spiritual traditions and philosophies. In Buddhism, one of the fundamental goals is the liberation from suffering and enlightenment. This is achieved through the practice of meditation, detachment from the ego, and the pursuit of wisdom and compassion. The aim is to reach a state of nirvana or Buddhahood, where the ego is transcended and the true nature, considered divine, is manifested. Hinduism also advocates for the pursuit of enlightenment and spiritual realization. The concept of moksha refers to liberation from the cycle of reincarnation and union with the divine, Brahman. This is achieved through self-realization, meditation, and spiritual knowledge. Sufism is a mystical branch of Islam that seeks direct union with God. Sufis practice meditation and deep contemplation, as well as purification of the ego through love and devotion to God. They seek to experience intimate communion with the divine. In Christianity, especially in mystical traditions like Gnostic Christianity or Christian mysticism, the emphasis is on seeking union with God through contemplation and direct experience of the divine. Christian mystics seek to transcend the ego and experience the presence of God within. Taoism promotes harmonization with the Tao, considered the primordial and divine source of all things. Through meditation, simplicity, and the natural flow of life, Taoists seek to transcend the ego and live in harmony with the divine. The teachings of Plato and Neoplatonic philosophers such as Plotinus suggest that the sensible world is an imperfect reflection of the world of ideas or forms, which is eternal and divine. Neoplatonic philosophy advocates the search for truth and beauty as a path to transcend material reality and connect with the divine. These are just some of the traditions that seek the perfection of the soul and manifestation from the divine instead of the individual ego. Each of them has specific practices and teachings that help individuals progress on this spiritual path toward transcending the selfish self and connecting with the sacred. If you enjoyed this content, we ask for your help in sharing the light of this knowledge by subscribing to our channel, giving it a like, and sharing this video with your friends and family. Your support is essential to us and motivates us to continue sharing valuable information with you. We invite you to participate in the comments section. We would love to hear your thoughts, questions, and suggestions for future topics you would like to see on our channel. Thanks again for your support, and remember, your like is our reward. A fraternal hug, and see you in the next video.